What's going on, everybody? Gareth here, FCP Euro, and this is going to be a tech tip video specifically for N52, N54, N55, N20, and N26 engines. Pretty much any BMW that has an external electrically driven water pump. This process is specifically for the self-bleeding procedure that is built into the car. Requires no special tools, so if you're doing, you know, radiator replacement, water pump replacement, oil filter housing gasket replacement, because you do have to open the cooling system for that, I'm gonna teach you how to go about turning the self-bleeding procedure on, and a couple things you need to be aware of when you're doing this. So for those of you that may be familiar with older BMW straight sixes, and maybe if you even own one, you would already know that some of those older engines, you know, M50s and E36s and M52s, M54s, those cooling systems can be extremely difficult to bleed and they are prone to airlocks. So on the later generation, you know, N5X and N2X family of engines, with the electric water pump, BMW has a self-bleeding procedure that pretty much takes care of the entire bleeding process for you. You do need a good battery charge for it. So if you have a weak battery, this probably won't work because it won't actually turn on if the battery voltage is too low. In the BMW TIS manual, it does say that the car should be on a battery maintainer. That's not a trickle charger. It does need to be high amp, probably 30, 40 amp continuous. But if your vehicle has a good battery, this is about 8 to 10 minute process and you shouldn't need to do any type of battery maintainer. So step one here, this is all hypothetical. Haven't actually touched the cooling system on this car, but we're just gonna turn on. So you're gonna turn the vehicle on so that it is in accessory mode. And from this point, you wanna turn the heat all the way up, as high as it'll go. And I'm gonna turn, in this car's case, it does have four zone climate control, but I want the fan speed on the lowest setting. So I'm gonna turn auto off and I'm just gonna manually knock down the fan speed to the slowest. So 84 degrees is the highest it'll go. Fan speed is set at the lowest. And now from this point, I'm just gonna hold the accelerator pedal down until the water pump turns on. It should take about 10 seconds. And I hear it just turned on. I can hear some squirting. And so really this will go for, you know, 8 to 10 minutes. It'll just turn itself off. So in the meantime, really you can kind of just do whatever else you need on the car. Don't shut the doors, don't roll up any windows, just leave the car as it is. And yeah, it's a really nice feature because for once, bleeding out a cooling system on one of these cars is not a major pain. Especially, like I said, if you own an older BMW, you already know the struggle on that. So as you can see, it's super easy to turn on the self-bleeding function that's built in these cars. So if you have an N52, N54, N55, N20, or N26 powered BMW, you can easily do this yourself. Like I said, just make sure you have a really good battery charge. If the battery is weak, you are gonna need to have some type of power supply on it to make sure that it doesn't shut off in the middle of it. It runs for about 8 to 10 minutes. You'll know when it turns off because everything goes eerily silent. But it's also really nice too because it gives you the opportunity to check for leaks. Obviously it confirms that the brand new water pump that you may have installed functions correctly. So overall, it's actually a really nice built-in feature. And for those of you that weren't aware that it existed, now you know. And for those of you that weren't sure how to activate it, now you know. So we hope you learned something. If you have any questions or comments, leave in the comment box below. We'll get back to you. Hit that like button and hit subscribe. We're gonna play more videos on the way. And as always, we'll see you for the next one. Later.